Look at this map of the countries with the highest number of people with naturally red hair in Europe. Now look at this map that shows the countries with the most people with light eyes in Europe, such as blue, green and grey. As you can see, there is a strong overlap in places like Scotland and Ireland, with these countries probably having the highest rates of people with red hair and blue eyes in the world. Other places, however, such as Scandinavia and the Udmurt Republic in Russia, also have reasonable levels of this combination. In fact, one reason why red hair is relatively common in parts of Scandinavia is because the Vikings took Scottish and Irish slaves back home, an interesting point to note at least. But what is the origins of this combination of red hair and blue eyes? What peoples down through history had these features, and how did these traits spread to Europe in the first place? Well, the first thing to note is that these features, red hair with blue eyes, is the rarest hair and eye colour combination on Earth. The overlap of these traits is extremely small, with it estimated that the percentage of people across the globe with red hair and blue eyes is only 0.17%. The reason why this combination is so rare is because it is caused by at least two separate genetic mutations, both of which are considered recessive traits, meaning that you need to inherit the same recessive allele for both traits from both parents for this combination to appear. As a general overview, redheads have a variant of the melanocortin 1 receptor gene, MC1R, located on chromosome 16, which is involved in melanin production and is the primary driver of red hair. Blue eyes, on the other hand, are linked to another genetic mutation in the HER2 gene, which influences the expression of the adjacent OCA2 gene, a gene that is again involved in melanin production. So in order to have red hair and blue eyes, you need to have both this MC1R mutation and also this mutation on the HER2 gene that affects the expression of the OCA2 gene. Now I should note that research in recent years has indicated that the genetics of eye and hair colour is much more complicated than this, with other genes playing a role as well. However, these two separate mutations are still some of the main drivers of both red hair and blue eyes developing, but what is the origin of this combination, and what peoples down through history had this combination of features? Well, let's start at the beginning, the Neanderthals. Did the Neanderthals have these traits, and if so, could we have inherited these traits from interbreeding, which we know happened? Well, we certainly know that Neanderthals had red hair, and some of them probably also had lighter eyes as well, so potentially a very small percentage of Neanderthals had this combination of red hair and blue eyes, perhaps in a similar percentage to modern humans. Yet from the research we have at the moment, it seems that the genetic mutations that caused these traits in Neanderthals were different to modern humans, and we are more certain of this for red hair at least, as a 2007 study concluded. Our data suggests that inactive MC1R variants evolved independently in both modern humans and Neanderthals. So when and where did red hair and blue eyes first emerge in modern humans then? Well, research from the early 2000s indicated that the gene variation that causes red hair could go back to around 100,000 years ago. Common estimates of how old the variant is are usually somewhere between 30,000 and 80,000 years ago, however, and it seems that the most likely location for red hair first emerging was in Central Asia. Some argue that blue eyes could have first developed as far back as around 42,000 years ago, much older than the 6,000 to 10,000 years ago that a 2008 study first estimated. The exact location is not known, however. It was previously speculated around the Black Sea region, and it actually could be in this general region, although further research is definitely needed. Arguably, as modern humans moved through the Middle East and into Europe for the first time. What about more recent history though? What descriptions have we got of people down through history that had these features of red hair and blue eyes? Well, let's start with a famous one, the most famous one probably, the Thracians. A people who lived in an area of southeast Europe, which included parts of modern Bulgaria, Romania, North Macedonia, and northern Greece. Writing in the 6th century BC, Xenophanes described the Thracians as blue-eyed and red-haired, which is pretty interesting given that they lived in southeast Europe. Another ancient people was described as having blue eyes and red hair as the Bedini, an ancient Scythian tribe that lived near the Vokhla River, which runs through parts of Russia and Ukraine. As well as the Bedini, the broader Scythians were described as having people with red hair and light eyes in historical descriptions, with the 2nd century Greek philosopher, Polemon, including the Scythians among the northern peoples characterised by red hair and blue-grey eyes, for example. Now, we know that the Scythians were an equestrian nomadic people who had migrated during the 9th to 8th centuries BC from Central Asia to the Pontic Steppe and modern-day Ukraine and parts of Russia. As we know that the Scythians moved west from Central Asia, this lends support to the idea that red hair first arose in Central Asia, not Europe. What is even more interesting is how many descriptions of people there are in Central Asia with red hair down through history, and the sources of these descriptions often come in quite surprising places, considering that Scotland, Ireland and Celtic peoples are associated with red hair today, for the most part, as these descriptions are often found in Chinese sources. Before we look at that, I would like to quickly thank my Patreon members for voting for this video topic. If you would like to vote for what video topics I make videos on, I'll put a link to my Patreon page below. Thanks for your support, and now on with the video. For example, there are interesting descriptions of a Turkic nomadic people who lived in the Eurasian steppe during the Middle Ages called the Kipchaks. In the Great Ming Code, which was the legal code of the Ming Dynasty, which ruled China from the 14th to the 17th century, the Kipchaks were described as vile from a Chinese perspective, having blonde or red hair and blue or green eyes. Now, another Turkic-speaking people who are described as having red hair was the Yenisei Kyrgyz, who lived along the Yenisei River from the 3rd century BC to the 13th century AD. And a book on the institutional history of the Tang Dynasty, published in 961 AD, it describes the Kyrgyz as all having red hair and green eyes. Now, I should note that some people have argued that both these Turkic people got their red hair from mixing with the Slavs at some point, with early Slavic peoples associated with red hair to some degree as well. Yet another example of people with red hair in this general area of Central Asia is the Tarim mummies, a number of mummies discovered in the Tarim Basin in present-day Xinjiang, China, who date from around 2100 to the 1st centuries BC. Ancient Chinese sources describe some of these people as having features associated more with European traits, such as red or blonde hair and deep-set blue or green eyes, which many scholars initially scoffed at as fantasy. More recent findings have legitimised these ancient Chinese descriptions, however, confirming that some of these people had red hair and likely had lighter eye colours, such as blue or green. So all these historical descriptions support the idea that red hair originated in Central Asia, and probably the first people that had red hair and blue eyes were probably seen in Asia rather than Europe. There are other historical figures connected to Central Asia that are worth noting as well. This is a picture of Ismail I, for example, the founder and first Shah of Safavid Iran, ruling from 1501 until his death in 1524. He had red hair and a fair complexion, as you can see, which is not something you usually associate with Persia. Another people connected to Central Asia and red hair, of course, is the Udmurt people, who live in the Volga region of Russia still today, but I'm going to look at them in more detail in a future video. Now, this is not to say that the only descriptions of people down through history that had red hair was in Central Asia. Obviously, Celtic peoples, Germanic peoples are two main branches of that. But the weight of the evidence, the weight of the historical descriptions, is not actually in Europe when it comes to red hair. It's actually in Central Asia, again supporting this idea that Central Asia was the origin of red hair. And obviously, the mixing of blue eyes and red hair is not 100% clear, but it potentially was in Asia rather than Europe. But this leads to an obvious question. Why do we see the traits of red hair and blue eyes more in places like Scotland and Ireland today, though? Well, we obviously know that blue eyes have a long tradition in Europe. They were very common amongst Western hunter-gatherers, for instance, yet they mainly had dark hair, not red hair. This didn't seem to be a feature of them at all. So why red hair and blue eyes then? Well, red hair probably came to Europe from Asia at some point, although we don't know the exact migration. But I'm going to explore a strange connection between Scotland and Scythia a little later. First, let's look at some practical reasons why red hair and blue eyes is found in higher rates in places like Scotland and Ireland in general compared to the rest of the world. One reason is probably connected to higher latitudes. We know that most people with red hair also have fair skin, with lighter skin better at making vitamin D from sunlight and thus better suited to places with less sunlight. I live in Scotland and at this time in the winter, it gets dark about 3:30 in the afternoon, which is not fun. We know as well that lighter eyes are more sensitive to light, and again probably better suited to northern latitudes. Although not too far north, snow blindness is an issue for Inuit populations and other indigenous populations of the Arctic zone. This is a picture of a man wearing snow goggles, for example, which Inuit and other indigenous peoples have made down through history from wood and other materials to protect their eyes against snow blindness caused by sunlight reflecting off the snow. So climate probably acted as a selective pressure that meant that people with red hair, blue eyes and lighter skin were better suited to places like Scotland. Sexual attractiveness could also play the role as well, as red hair and blue eyes is once again the rarest hair and eye colour combination in the world, and humans tend to value things that are rare. Now, another point I will note is a bit of a strange one, and it's connected to the Scythians, is more food for thought than anything else. But as I noted earlier, the Scythians had relatively high levels of people with red hair amongst them. What is curious, though, is how many connections there are between the origins of different Scottish populations, the Scots and the Picts, and the Scythians. This is the 1320 Declaration of Arbroath, for example, one of the most famous documents in Scottish history. It states that the origin of the Scots was in Greater Scythia, before they travelled across Europe to eventually settle in Scotland. As the declaration states, "Most Holy Father, we know him from the chronicles and books of the ancients, we find that among other famous nations, our own, the Scots, had been graced with widespread renown. It journeyed from Greater Scythia by way of the Tyrrhenian Sea and the Pillars of Hercules, and dwelt for a long course of time in Spain, among the most savage peoples, but nowhere could it be subdued by any people. Thence it came, 1200 years after the people of Israel crossed the Red Sea, to its home in the west where it still lives today." An origin story of the Picts of ancient Scotland also connects them to Scythia. It comes from Bede, a monk from Northumbria who wrote the ecclesiastical history of the English people in the 8th century AD. He writes that the Pictish race from Scythia sailed out into the ocean in a few warships and were carried by the wind beyond the furthest bounds of Britain, reaching Ireland. The Irish answered that the island would not hold both of them, but said they, "We know another island not far from our own, in an easterly direction, which we often see in the distance on clear days." Now, to be clear, I'm not arguing that this is 100% fact, but it's a strange connection that is found in more than one primary source, and it's odd that the Scythians are also connected to red hair. Could there be some connection here, some truth here? Could a group of Scythians have sailed and somehow reached Scotland and contributed to this feature of red hair here in Scotland? Who knows, but please let me know your thoughts below. Overall, red hair and blue eyes probably evolved as a combination of genetic mutations, selective pressures, and who knows, perhaps ancient connections between parts of the world you wouldn't think were connected. Regardless of this, the origins of red hair do seem to be in Central Asia, with this trait only spreading to Europe over time and mixing with blue eyes at some point. Now, we know that Celtic peoples have been associated with lighter eyes and red hair down through history, but what is the genetics of Celtic peoples? To find out, please click here. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and hit the bell, and let me know your thoughts below. If you would like to vote for what video topics I make videos on, I will put a link below to my Patreon page as well. But thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.